come the Longhorns.
It's got to be exciting for college fans everywhere as we prepare for the national championship with this incredible season drawing closer to an end. Texas is lined up for the opening kickoff, so here we go. He's to the 10, he's to the 20, at the 30, at the 40, and he's tackled at the 46-yard line.
You gotta love opening the game with a solid kick return like this.
For TCU, Kirk, just give us an overview of what kind of style we're going to see from this offense today.
I think the disadvantage of running a spread attack is whether or not you have the proper personnel to really make a difference in running this offense. If you've got the personnel, if you have the quarterback and a running back who can really make teams pay for that, you got some speed on the outside. This is an offense that's very difficult to stop.
He fights forward to about the 46. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. They can't hear a thing down there. Hill drops back. Nice grab on the play. Tackle at the 30.
You know, having a playmaker at tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That can be just enough time for the quarterback.
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it.
Newsom was the intended receiver.
From the 30-yard line. Second down. And they make the stop at the 33. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 20. This crowd a huge factor right now against this offense. Drops back to pass. Throws it out, and it falls incomplete. Nickel, he'd like to change field position with his punt. Touchback. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. From their own 20-yard line, first down. He has some room. And he hits him hard at the 31-yard line.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? He better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
From their own 31-yard line, it's first down. Quick pass, knocked out of bounds, right around the 40.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Short yardage situation here, second down and one. Brought down at the 43-yard line. First down pick up by the tailback.
You can see how comfortable this guy is with that football in his arms.
From their own 43-yard line. First down. Here's the give. They'll bring him down around the 46-yard line.
They've got a solid drive going here. But I know it's not going to mean that much without putting some points up on the board.
First and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. Williams gets a call. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop him short of the line of scrimmage.
From the 47-yard line, it's second down. Ready. And he's tackled at the 45. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
Third down.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36.
Hunt!
He gets sacked on the play.
Loss of 11 yards.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long.
That makes it fourth and long.
Johnson will be the return man. Brought down at the 24. The offense will take over at the 24-yard line. After a decent run up the gut.
Call it a gain of 4 yards.
Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 28. Inside handoff. Tackle made around the 39-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards.
From their own 39-yard line. First down. Run left side, gets to about the 41-yard line. The running back gets two on the carry.
That makes it second and eight.
From their own 41-yard line, second down. He's tackled at the 39. The defensive end was the victor on that play as he bolted in to tackle him for a loss.
And he was able to do that because the interior linemen held their ground, leaving the runner with no options.
Really a factor with the crowd noise here. Finds his halfback, first down.
That's a gain of 19 on the play. First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 42. They'll run the option. And down he goes, right around the 22-yard line.
A gain of 20 yards.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 22. Gets out to about the 21. We played one. Still no score.
That brings up second and nine.
From the 21-yard line, it's second down. Taken down at about the 19-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive.
That makes it 37.
And he's taken down at the 20. It's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. TCU is looking to go up by three. It's up, and they tack on 3 points. Carter has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He hits a booming kick. He's to the 10, he's to the 20, and down he goes at the 25. The offense will start at the 25-yard line. It's the tailback, and he carries the ball for a nice gain.
Gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
Pitch left. He's at midfield. At the 30. To the 20, to the 10, and he will score.
Wow. When you see that end zone in front of you, it can elevate your running to another level. Awesome play.
Texas has a three-point lead. And he hits the PAT. A quick two-play, 75-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
The score now, 7-3.
Johnson
Smith is lined up to kick this one off. He'll return it from the one. Across the 30. Down the sideline. And he's finally brought down at the 35-yard line. They'll take over at the 35-yard line. Option to the right. He makes it to the 35-yard line.
No gain on the play.
From the 35-yard line. Second down. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gain of 6 on the play.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Becoming the 12th man, the crowd is always into it here. Option left side. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Branch, the ball carrier. Nice run there.
Really big boost for this offense, picking up that fourth down conversion. The running play was very well designed.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 21. Fires out quickly to the tailback. Touchdown, TCU! Trying to go up by 3, they'll kick the extra point. TCU with a 2-point advantage. He makes the PAT. A 5-play, 35-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
Carter ready to kick. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 10. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 30. They'll go to work at the 30-yard line. And they make the stop at the 33.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make
second and 7. Ball on their own 33. Halfback gets the call, and he answers big time. Tackle around the 45-yard line.
He gets another set of downs, and more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
First and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. Looking to throw. Brought down at the 38-yard line.
Pretty nice pickup here. These guys are getting very tight on their timing.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Offense lines up in a 5-wide set and a defense anticipating pass here. The Longhorns will use their first time out of the half. McKinney back to pass. He launches one for the end zone.
Oh, boy. I bet he knew as soon as he released that football that he shouldn't have made the throw. And that's the thing. When you're under that kind of pressure, it takes away that one split second you need to scan the area so you know where it's a safe throw.
TCU is up a field goal. They'll bring him down at the 37.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 37. He's scrambling. And they got it. TCU's going to use their first time out of the half here.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Hill steps back to pass. And he's knocked out immediately after the catch.
Call it a gain of 14 yards.
From midfield, it's first down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds.
That's good for a gain of 16 yards.
From the 34-yard line, first down. Drops back to pass. Going for it all to the end zone.
Thompson, the intended receiver on the play.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. And he's tackled at the 32-yard line.
The Horned Frogs call a timeout. That's their second of the half.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. He zips it. Incomplete pass. A little too high for his receiver.
When you throw the football into the end zone, you've got to be extremely accurate. You don't have any room for errors.
So it's fourth down. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. He drops back. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
Did you see how calm he looked as he stood back there and read the defense? When you know what you're doing and what should be happening, it makes things a lot easier.
He's tackled right around the 18-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
TCU holds a field goal lead. He's looking to pass. Throws it in a hurry. And now the ball is loose.
That just shows you how determined this defense is. Great play by the linebacker to come up with the ball after the fumble.
They'll go to work at the 18. Tackle made at the 13.
Well, that's just a good call from the defensive side of the football. They know what this team likes to run, and they got the better of them that time.
From their own 13-yard line, it's second down. A great first half comes to a close. 10-7, Horned Frog. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. The offense will take over at the 23-yard line. And he has it on the corner. He's taken down at the 38.
There's nothing more effective that a team can do offensively than to pound the ball right at the defense, trying to wear them down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 38. Williams on the pitch to the right. He's at the 40. Down the sideline! And down he goes, right around the 22-yard line.
That was a good-looking play, and it sort of caught the defense off guard.
Let's see now how the defense responds to giving up the gain on the run. It up the middle. tackled after a decent pickup. Brown gained 7 yards on that play. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And he's taken down at about the 13. A yard, maybe two on the carry. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. They go with the option. On the pitch, look out, loose ball.
It didn't really seem to me that anybody on this offense really knew where that option was going. Fortunately for them, they were able to hang on to the ball.
Texas can tie it up here with this kick. He gets it up, and it is good. They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This drive will start at the 25. Gives it off. And he hits him hard at the 35.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. They'll get him for a loss. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. The intimidation factor is definitely here when you're playing in this stadium. Pushed out of bounds around the 33-yard line. Nickel is waiting for the snap. Williams takes it at the 33. He's taken down at the 33-yard line. They'll get the ball here at the 33. He gets to about the 41-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Tosses it out. He tackles him for a loss.
The defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
McKinney comes from their own 32-yard line. It's third down. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
Smith awaits the snap. Tackle made at the 35-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 35. Hill on the option. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. A yard, if that, on the quarterback keeper. From their own 35-yard line. Second down. Johnson gets a handoff to the right. Makes it out to about the 43. A gain of 8 on the carry. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. They can't hear a thing down there. Hill, the ball carrier. He fights forward to about the 46. He didn't get much, but he got enough for the first down.
Well, that's really all they wanted there was to pick up the first down and get a fresh set of downs and continue to move the ball downfield.
And they make the stop around the 49-yard line.
That's a gain of 5 on the play.
Second down and 5. Ball on the 49. on the ground, inside. That's a great tackle at the 30.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? He better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
From the 30-yard line, first down. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
From the 33-yard line, second down. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. They go with a run. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Branch gets 6 yards after taking the handoff on the draw play. This is the eighth play of this drive. These fans are showing you why teams hate to come here, folks. Ross gets the ball. Tackle at the 29-yard line.
Good, solid defense there to force him into a fourth down situation.
Fourth down. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Back to pass. He's looking for six. Brought down at the 1 yard line.
That's good for a gain of 29 yards.
First and goal as they look to take the lead. They go with the back, and he's in for the touchdown. The halfback just plowed his way into the end zone.
Yeah, but it wasn't all him. The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
TCU is up by six. And he tacks on the extra point. A nice 9-play, 66-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Carter has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He's to the 20. At the 40. Across midfield, and he's finally taken down at the 43. The finish line's in sight. Let's see who wants this one more.
Brad, really, this is what it's all about. The offense going up against the defense. Over 2 minutes to go in the game. It's a one-possession game. Can the offense put it together and try to put a drive possibly to tie this game or take the lead?
And they'll look to capitalize on the good field position here.
Feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
From the 43-yard line, it's second down. Hands it to the back, and he is drilled at the 29.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
And for Williams, looks to be a little slow getting up. First and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. He gets out to about the 17-yard line.
Just a simple draw play there, but they picked up some big yards.
From the 17-yard line, it's first down. The halfback with a carry. They'll bring him down at the 14-yard line. The back gets three on the carry.
And he took a shot on that play, Brad. It looks like his head might be still ringing a little bit.
From the 14-yard line, second down. Tackle made at the 11. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
With the defensive line neutralizing the blocks, these linebackers are able to come up and make plays in the holes.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. McKinney. Options out to the left. And he's tackled
at about the 11.
They might have been able to catch the defense off guard with a play-action pass there. But by going to the ground, they didn't have much of an opening.
He's taken down at the 10.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
So a big drive for this offense. They put themselves in a great position with the lead here in the fourth quarter. And if they can sustain this drive, use some clock, and get any kind of score, they'd be in great shape to win the game.
He's to the 20.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 27.
The Longhorns taking their first time out of the half.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 27. Looking to throw. Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
Second and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line. They bring him down in the backfield.
Well, that's just a good call from the defensive side of the football. They know what this team likes to run, and they got the better of them that time.
Third down and 14 to go.
Ball on the 23. He gets sacked on the play. Texas will take their last time out. Fourth and long here after the sack. Gunn is back to receive. He's taken down the 39-yard line. Flags are down, and this one might be on the offense. That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. Just under two to go in the game. Back to pass. He flings it right. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
You know, having a playmaker at tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That can be just enough time for the quarterback.
From the 27-yard line, first down. Inside the 10, and he got it to the sophomore.
The wideout here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
Boy, that had to be a miscue of some kind or a mental error by the defense. This wide receiver was just too open for there not to be some kind of mistake by the defense. I'm sure the defensive coordinator is going to want to get his defense on the sideline and to make sure everybody's on the same page.
And he adds the extra point.
Smith has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 10. He's to the 20. At the 30. At the 40. The 50. At the 40. To the 20. To the 10.
Touchdown, Horned Frogs. Gigantic play, and it came at a great time.
And he converts the extra point. So with less than two to go in the fourth quarter, the score is 24-17, TCU. He boots it deep downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And this will be pretty much it for this offense. They need to capitalize on this possession. Here's the halfback on the screen. He's to the 40. Down the sideline. And they finally knock him out at the 42.
That's a smart call to exploit the pass rush and open up some space for him. The blockers did a good job of selling that play.
Just over a minute in the fourth quarter.
Handoff inside. And down he goes at the 30-yard line. And the delayed handoff works for a big gain.
Got to be happy with the effort there by your tailback.
Guys, when we were at practice this week, you kind of got the feeling that they might run a little no huddle. In fact, here it comes.
Spikes the ball.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 30-yard line, second down.
Drops back to pass. He goes out of bounds at the 22.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. That's a backward pass. That's a live ball. And that fumble is going to cost him.
At this stage in the game, the number one rule has to be to hold on to the football.
This drive will start at the 37. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes a knee. From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. And they make the stop
right around the 38-yard line.
And the halfback carries for a pickup of three. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, 24-17, Horned Frog. The Longhorns, 17. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
Well, this one really could have gone either way. Texas had plenty of chances to win this football game, but it wasn't meant to be today. All you can do now is try to bounce back after a close loss like this.
Here's a look at today's player of the game. That's going to do it for this game of NCAA Football 13. My partners, Kirk Herbstreit and Aaron Andrews, Reese Davis in the studios, and everyone at EA Sports. I'm Brad Nessler, saying so long.